Hey guys, it's the Sunnyslope team again. Today we're going to be showing you how to make artwork inspired by The Little Mermaid. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make Flotsam and Jetsam, which are Ursula's eels from The Little Mermaid.
The supplies you're going to need are pipe cleaners, clay, blue, black, and gray paint, and a paintbrush. We're going to start off by shaping the pipe cleaner into the shape of an eel. We want it to where it has a curve, and if it's too long, you can always cut a little piece off just to get it the size that you want it. Now that we have the pipe cleaner and the shape that we want it, we're going to actually add clay onto it to form our eel. We're going to be rolling it up and just adding it all the way around. You're going to cover the pipe cleaner completely with the clay. Once you cover your pipe cleaner completely in clay, what you're going to do is you're going to shape your eel and give it that kind of curve, kind of like a snake. Next, what we're going to do is you're going to get another piece of clay. You're going to roll it out really thin, and it's going to go on top, on the very top of the eel. It's going to give it that top fin. And what you're going to do is once you add it on top, you're going to smooth it out so it doesn't look just round. It's going to look a part of it. So you're going to smooth it down. As you smooth the fin out, it kind of looks like a mohawk. So this is the finished product, and we're going to let it dry for a second. Once it's done drying, it may take longer for certain clays, you're going to paint it. I went with the original colors from the movie, but you can use whatever color that you want to paint your eel. And for some added fun, I made it under the sea background for it. I added Ursula's cave right there. You can do any type of background that you want using the same supplies that we used to make the eel.
Today we will be using a fork to paint the puffer fish from The Little Mermaid. You will need paint, construction paper, paint brushes, forks, colored pencils, markers, a bowl, scissors, glue, and pipe cleaners. Let's begin by creating a circle by tracing the bottom of a bowl. This will create the body of the pufferfish. Now grab a fork and dip the back of it in paint. Use the fork to start creating the pufferfish. Use two pipe cleaners to make fins for the pufferfish. Now go ahead and glue them towards the top of the circle. Use paper to cut out the eyes and mouth of the fish. I use scissors and a bottle to help me make a nice circle. Go ahead and glue them on. Fill in the eyes and the mouth. Great job! Here's how mine turned out. I hope you had fun recreating this.
Hey guys, it's Miss Brianna from Sunnyslope, and today we're going to make a 3D flounder scene. So what you're going to need is all the supplies right here, this flounder PDF, and the link is in the top if you need it. So the first thing you're going to do is color your flounder in, then you can cut him out and make all the folds where the dotted lines are. This process takes a little bit of time and is a little bit tricky, but if you follow the directions, it should come out looking right. It should look like this. Now for our box, you're going to need yarn, paper, tape, scissors, clay, pipe cleaners, and a shoebox. So this is the part where you can be super creative and make your ocean floor scene.
fish is happy as off through the waves they roll. The fish on the land ain't happy, they saw 'cause they in the bowl. But fish in the bowl is lucky, they in for a worse of fate. One day when the boss get hungry, yes, you go beyond
it. And here's me, I'm trying to decide where I want to put my founder, but like I said, it's totally up to you. I also used some yarn, tacked as seaweed, and for my coral reef. Under the sea we have to hook up. We got no troubles. Life is the bubbles under the sea. Under the sea. Under the sea. Under the sea. Since life is sweet here, we got to be here naturally. Even the sturgeon and the ray, did it the earth and start to play. We got the spirit, you got to hear it under the sea. These were all the things that I came up when I did this, and I even printed out some of Flounder's friends, Ursula, Ariel, and Sebastian.
Hi guys, this is Mr. Kel from Sunnyslope coming back to you with another video. This week we're going to be working on a DIY never-ending card. So this is what we're going to be working on. It's Disney themed this week. So we're going to be focusing on Ariel. So as you can see, this is mine that I've done. And it takes like 10 minutes. And it's basically every turn that you make is a different character. As you can see from The Little Mermaid. And we have Little Sebastian. And then we go back and it's Ariel again. So yeah, let's work. We're gonna be working on this today. I'm gonna show you how we're gonna put it together and what materials you'll need. So let's get started. As you can see, each time you turn and flip the card, you see the puzzle forming of each Little Mermaid character. And there you go. I hope you try it out. Until next time, bye.
Hola. Hoy vamos a hacer un cangrejito como este. Estos son los materiales que vamos a usar. Primero, en este pedazo de cartulina, dibuja dos círculos. Traza dos líneas hacia abajo en cada círculo. Con las tijeras corta el círculo así. Estas van a ser las pinzas. Después, en el otro pedazo de cartulina, dibuja dos ojos y una boca sonriendo. Enreda el tubo con la cartulina, asegúrala con cinta adhesiva. Pega las dos pinzas atrás del tubo. Corta dos limpiapipas por la mitad. Solamente usaremos tres pedazos para las patas. Pega los tres pedazos de limpiapipas atrás del tubo. Dobla el final de las puntas hacia abajo. Espero que te guste el proyecto que hicimos.
Hey guys, this is Mr. Jagger from Sunnyslope Elementary, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make flounder from The Little Mermaid.
Okay, so for the material you're going to need either a paper or a silhouette. I find it easier to have it like the printed picture with color so you can follow along the lines. You're gonna need a construction paper, so after you're done with this, you're just gonna glue it or tape it here. You're gonna need the yellow yarn that should have come with your art kit, and some pipe cleaners. I'm gonna be using purple, since we don't have like a blue color one, so purple is gonna be the closest to it. So let's get started. So to get started, I'm gonna be using a white pipe cleaner to follow the edges to not get it confused with other colors. So let's get started. So you're gonna want to follow along like the edge lines and just kind of put your shape, your thing into it. So after your art is ready and you have everything chipped in, you want to start to fill it in with the yarn, the yellow yarn. So just make sure you get enough so you can start filling it in. Then you cut it too. I find it easier to like get the tip of the yarn and tip it to like where your tape thing's already at, so it doesn't fall out. So after you filled it in, make sure to not leave any white or negative space out. And just kind of go along, and for the eyes, I just made like a little circle. And I'm going to place it right where the eyes are at. And I know it's not going to look like exactly good, but it's like what we can all do best. So you just cut like a little piece. And just kind of fold it inside. So here's the final product, and you're welcome to do any other character from the Disney movie Little Mermaid or from any other Disney shows, or perhaps even Cartoon Network. It's up to you. And you're also welcome to like add more color to it, like the stripes and everything. The mouth, you could make it bigger. And the eyes, you could also make it better. And if you want to hang it up on your wall or somewhere, you could add like a little pipe cleaner on the top part. And then just hang it on your wall like that. So have fun doing it.
Hola, buenas tardes. Mi nombre es Silvia García. Vamos a hacer un proyecto con papel de rollo, la parte de adentro, y vamos a hacer una sirenita. Ahorita les voy a mostrar el proyecto final. El producto final espero les guste y la puedan hacer en su casa. Ok, en este momento voy a decirle lo que ocupamos. Ocupamos, obviamente, el papel de rollo, la parte de adentro, el papel de rollo. Ocupamos tijeras, marcadores, regla, lápiz. Y decidir de qué color vamos a hacer y papel constructivo. Lo primero que yo hice fue cortarle el círculo para la parte de su cabecita porque decidí que fuera rosa su pelo. Después tomé y empecé a cortar su pelo. Ustedes lo van a poder enchinar ya sea con sus manos o lo van a poder enchinar con un lápiz. Este es el fleco. También todas las medidas vienen ahí porque está muy pequeño el tiempo. Después decidí hacerle la parte de su cuerpo. En su cuerpo ustedes lo van a poder decorar con marcador. Lo van a hacer como unas onditas así para que ustedes lo hagan en su casa, que no se les olvide. La otra cosa que ustedes decidan, si quieren le pueden poner glitter. También tiene que hacer la colita de la sirenita y decorarla. Y este va a ser el brasiercito. Todas las indicaciones están ahí. Van a ser dos conchitas. Y estas se le ponen aquí. Después, en este momento, lo que se puede hacer también es, aquí está el producto terminado otra vez. Yo lo decoré con estas dos pequeñas estrellas. Ustedes pueden decorarlo si gustan. Si quieren ponerle eso, si quieren poner otra cosa. Y que no se les olvide que tienen con un marcador pintarle sus ojitos de la sirenita para que se puedan verle poner más pestañas. Le pueden poner lo que ustedes gusten. Le pueden poner glitter. Y entonces ustedes pueden jugar con todas estas cositas en su casa. Jugar con sus hermanitos y distraerse un poquito. Que no se les olvide, por favor, hacer su tarea. Hacer lo que indique su mamá, ayudarles. Y esperemos vernos pronto. Los extrañamos. Bye, bye.
Hi, I'm Miss Michelle from Sunnyslope Elementary, and today I will be showing you guys how to do a holographic mermaid tail. You will be needing markers, glue, scissors, white paper, color paper, a pen and a pencil, and aluminum foil. We're going to start off by tracing your mermaid tail using a pencil. After you're done tracing your mermaid tail, you're going to start by cutting it. We will be using tin foil to trace over the mermaid tail. Once you've traced your mermaid tail onto your tinfoil, you can start cutting it. Once you guys cut the mermaid tail, I will be gluing it onto the colored paper. I will be using markers to color the tail. And there you guys have it, a holographic mermaid tail. You can also use your pen to draw in the scales, only if you want to. I hope you guys enjoyed the video and hope to see you guys soon.